I've been interested in Medea for 30 years now. I think she's fascinating because she's a leftover from an older world. She's at the time that Greeks imagine as the beginning of Western culture and literature, so the characters are all demigods. Her grandfather's the sun, for instance. They say this is the beginning, but it's a giant lie, because it's actually the end of a much older world. The fall of the Bronze Age, the fall of the Hittite Empire, the decline of the Egyptians. So Medea is a leftover, and she threatens the idea of that beginning. And then she's also a barbarian coming from a faraway land, so she's a threat in that way. And she's a threat because she thinks the rule of men is absurd. She's a destroyer of kings. She kills half a dozen kings and future kings, including her own two sons. So I like her for how much she's an outsider and a threat. And I wanted to tell a story, a version of her where she's not crazy and a witch and out of control and not so worried about Jason and doesn't want to kill her kids. So I wrote this, I hope, realistic and sympathetic version of someone smart who has a will to power. I've seen so many stage performances of Medea, and they all have her out of control and crazy and all thinking about Jason. And so I wanted something very different, something where she has her own life separate from Jason, is not actually that concerned about him, and is smart politically, and is good at destroying kings, and is good at finding some way to not be a slave. The threat, being a woman and an outsider, of course, is that she'll always be a slave wherever she goes, and she tries to find ways to have power anyway. And I wanted it to be a realistic story, because I didn't want any, you know, witchcraft or fantastic events to give her power and give her position. I wanted her to have to figure things out in a realistic way. And I love archaeology. I've visited all those sites, and the book is really accurate for 3,250 years ago. And I was actually the captain for an ancient Egyptian ship, which is what the Argo would have been. The Greeks can't have built a ship at that time period, a 20-meter ship. So I've actually been the captain and writing about my personal experience for what the Argo would have been for the sailing. So I tried to go back to what it would be really like to live then, what a mind would be like then, to a rougher, kind of more brutal form of language also, and trying to imagine Medea as a real person. I think that Greek tragedy is still completely relevant in our lives, certainly in my family's life and in my life, because it's about acting unconsciously and out of control. The truth is that the big decisions in my life, why I married who I married, why I couldn't stay married, I can't answer any of those questions. I made them unconsciously. I don't know why I did them. And that's true for most people. Most people are living their lives having no idea why they're doing what they're doing. That's how Greek tragedy still lives. So the Greeks knew that families make us and break us. There's those closest relationships that form us for our whole lives, and that we don't know what's going on in culture, in law, in religion, that all of that's unconscious for us too, and that when terrible things happen, when a taboo is broken, all those rules are called into question, and we have to ask ourselves what makes a family, what makes a society, what makes a self, that we're constantly in crisis over that. So to me, the Greeks are completely relevant, and Medea's struggle is something we're still experiencing. We still have the rule of men completely absurd. We have Trump. I wanted to write another ancient story from 1,200 years ago in Anglo-Saxon England, because I've translated Beowulf from 1,200 years ago. And my publisher specifically, my U.S. publisher, doesn't want me to do that, and made the contract for my next book say that it would be a contemporary novel. So I really didn't like that they said what I can or can't write. So I've written several contemporary novels since that contract, but I'd like to go back to write something in Anglo-Saxon England or rewrite another Greek myth. Even if no one's going to read them and no one cares, it's what I think is beautiful and what I care about. So I would like to do it anyway.